Hello coders, welcome back. So today we will see how we will connect our client app, that is our task app, with our server, which we coded in the previous videos. So here is our client app coding or task app coding, and here we have already written the methods, and we have also shown in the part 5 that how we can deserialize JSON which we get from server. So we just use JSON generator. But now, since we already have our data in MongoDB Atlas, you can see these all data. So we can try displaying it in our app. So instead of having these data from JSON generator, we'll have whatever data we have here in this MongoDB Atlas. So for that, we just need to change this URL here, and rest of the code is already here. But yeah, I will explain the code again here also so that you can get more clarity. So for that we need to get the URL. So we can easily get the URL. See, here we already have the URL, but if you want, you can just use Heroku open to get the URL. It will open web browser, and in that you can get the base URL. Okay, so you can see this is our base URL. We'll copy it. And in our here we just have to paste it. Okay, now this is just the base URL but not the endpoint. If you remember, here we have done similar thing. This is our base URL for the okay, we are doing get. Okay, I haven't done the get using this. Okay, anyway, so this is our base URL up till here, and then from here /user task to create user task. This is our endpoint which we created. So now we just have to provide our endpoint in our client app. So the endpoint for getting user task from MongoDB Atlas, if you remember, is /get user task. You can check it in node.js server which we have created and verify it. Do remember to check it carefully, the naming. Just hot restart and see. Okay, we are not getting anything, but let's check our debug console. See, in the debug console you can see in the response.body here we are printing response.body. So you can see here in the response.body we are getting whatever we had in the MongoDB Atlas: learn and grow, and then task description. Learning is very important. So here we are getting it, but we are not able to display it here. So that's because we have, see here we have named it task title, but if you go to model class here, we have named this task name, and here also from JSON method means whatever we are getting this JSON. So we are using the name task name, but here it is task title. So to make it work, we just need to give it task title. And just hot restart the app. Okay, now you can see learn and grow and whatever we had in the database, we are able to see it here. But again, for the task description, we are not able to see the task description. So for that, again, we'll just copy this, paste it here, and hot restart our app. It is still not displayed in our app, so let's just check our UI coding and see if we have done the correct coding to display the task details. Okay, let's just check our task template. Okay, so here we have hard coded it, so we'll just replace it to make it dynamic. Okay, we have task detail. Cool. Now let's see. Okay, now you can see here task title is also there, and then learning is very important, which is our task description. These are also here. So we have successfully fetched whatever data we had in our MongoDB Atlas database. That is from here. We have successfully displayed it in our app. Okay, so now let's understand the code. So we'll first restart, hot restart. And okay, you can see here display controller has been initialized. So as soon as our app restarts or app opens, so display controller is initialized, and in the display controller we have onInit method where we are calling get task from DB. So get task from DB, and here we are calling getting task from DB. Just to make code more clean, we have made this method again. So here this is a future method, and here we are doing the actual code of network handling API call and endpoints. So here in the URL we have provided the URL which we got after deploying to Heroku, and then supplied the endpoint which we had created. And now we are in the response, we are using HTTP package to get the response. So this HTTP takes the URL and it stores the response value in this variable. So in this response variable we have status code, we have response body also. So we first check if the response code is 200. If the response code is 200, that means everything is okay and we got the correct thing what we desired. So we are just printing it out for our own sake to check everything is right or not. And then in the another variable, after we are checking okay response is okay, then in another variable we have named it task JSON, and we have just, you see, if you see here JSON.decode, it parses the string and returns resulting JSON object. So whatever we got in response.body, we are decoding it and getting JSON object so that we can use it in our task model. So here, and for then we have used for loop, and then in that for where JSON in task JSON, we have created task model object for each JSON object and then added it in our display task list. And we are calling it here display task list, and we are displaying it here. So this is what is happening here in this. Pretty simple, I guess. And yeah, one more thing to take care is that here you see we have task name, task detail as our name for the fields. And in our server, I had named it differently. But we don't have to do that. We have to give the same naming so that later on we don't have to change anything. Okay, so here we have given task title, task description. So generally try to give same naming here also, task name. In this place we should have task title, task details. It's every, now also everything is working fine. Just for our own, for the developer's sake, try to give same naming in both the model classes, in the client side also and in the server side also, so that it becomes easier to maintain and we don't have to change. Like here we needed to change it because we had different name, but if we give the same name and then we don't have to change it. But yeah, anyways, this is working fine, you can see. And I named it differently just to show you guys which values are being used where. So that was the only purpose. But when we do actual coding for any project or when we work in a team, we should give a same naming just to make the code simpler and collaborate in the team. Yeah, but yeah, this one necessary so that your doubts can be cleared. Okay, so in the next video we will see how to make post request and send data from our client app to our server, which will store it in the backend. So we'll give details here, click on post, and then it will be stored in our MongoDB Atlas. Okay, till then, take care. Bye bye.